First, they say, well, the peace agreement between Israel and Syria will help Israel to confront with Iran, because if Syria signs a peace agreement with Israel, of course it might affect the relationship between Syria and Iran. Number one, it is not going to affect the relationship between Syria and Iran. And the Syrians say it in a very explicit way. They say, our relationship with third country is not and cannot be part of this deal. Number two, it is true that Syria needs Iran, but Iran does not need Syria. And of course, Iran does not need Syria whenever the nuclear issue is concerned. In other words, if the most dangerous matter for Israel is the Iranian nuclear project, then this project is not going to be influenced whatsoever whether Israel does have a peace agreement with Syria or does not have. But this is number one. Number two, we said that, well, a peace agreement between Israel and Syria might bring eventually to a peace agreement or better relationship between Israel and Lebanon. Who said? It is true that this was the reality 9 or 10 years ago, because 10 years ago, Syrians did control Lebanon, formally. And it was well perceived by everyone that the control of Lebanon is in the hands of the Syrians. So when Israel and Syria did have a negotiation 10 years ago, Israel could demand that a peace agreement between Israel and Syria would also include a peace agreement between Israel and Lebanon. But today, the Syrians officially are not in Lebanon. They were kicked out by the international community 4 years ago, and they say, we are not responsible for Lebanon, so it is not our problem. Now, whenever we talk about Lebanon, Lebanon is actually controlled by Hezbollah. And Hezbollah is much more independent in regard to the Syrians than the way that some people believe that they are under certain Syrian control. And the Iranians are much more committed to the Iranian. Hezbollah is much more committed to the Iranian rather than to Syria. So Hezbollah will continue to exist whether Israel does have a peace agreement with Syria or not. And the Syrians don't even intend to do anything in order to change it. And if we are talking about the nature of the negotiation that we did have with the Syrians in the past few months, no one mentioned the possibility to stop this negotiation unless the Syrians make a commitment that they can bring to the table the Lebanese with them. It was not part of the deal, it was not part of the terms of reference. So Lebanon today is an independent state in regard to the Syrian official possibility to make a commitment. So Hezbollah will continue to exist. Number three, people say, well, but Hezbollah will be much weaker because the supply of weapons from Syria or via Syria that is now part of the ordinary relationship between Syria and Hezbollah will stop. Who says? Let's take the relationship between Egypt and Gaza. There is only 12 kilometers of border between Egypt and Gaza. Egypt is officially committed to stop all the flow of weapons from Egypt to Gaza, and they're committed not only to Israel, they're committed to the United States. 12 kilometers of desert, which are very easily can be monitored, and still there is a flow of weapons from Egypt to Gaza. Whenever we talk about the border between Egypt and Lebanon, we're talking about hundreds of kilometers of very rough terrain, and the flow of weapons from Syria to Lebanon to Hezbollah will continue for the simple reason, because the Syrian interest to continue to equip Hezbollah will continue, and there is no way to stop it. So it is not only that Hezbollah will continue to exist, but the flow of weapons will continue. And besides, the Syrians are not the only supply of weapons to Iran, to Hezbollah, and Iran can find some other creative ways to send some of the weapons to Hezbollah. So this problem is not going to be solved again, even if a peace agreement between Israel and Syria is achieved. Number four, we are told that a peace agreement between Israel and Syria might have positive effect on the Israeli-Palestinian trade. I have a different idea. I think that it would have a very negative impact, because I don't think that Israel can conduct simultaneously two strikes. And if we prefer the Syrians and we move forward with the Syrians, the Palestinians might feel that they are again left behind. And this kind of frustration might even bring to another Palestinian intifada. But anyway, a peace, an Israeli-Syrian peace negotiation is not going to be helpful to the Israeli-Palestinian dialogue. Number five, we are told, well, if we have a peace agreement between Israel and Syria, then the headquarters of Hezbollah and Islamic Jihad would have to be removed from Syria because this is going to be one of the very strict demands of the state of Israel. Let's assume that it can be achieved. Why it is so important? Why it is so important where are the location of the headquarters of Hamas? And if they are not in Damascus and they move to Sudan or to Somalia, what is the difference? I would even say the opposite. If there is a peace agreement between Israel and Syria, I prefer that Hamas headquarters would continue to stay in Damascus because at least I have certain influence there. So even if it is achieved, it has no meaning whatsoever. Number six, the peace agreement between Israel and Syria is not going to have any positive effect on the relationship between the state of Israel and the Arab world. Just as a peace agreement between Israel and Jordan 15 years ago was not very helpful. Why? Because the Arab world has one card, and this is the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. As unless this problem is solved, they don't want to change, and they do not intend to change any of their views in regard to the state of Israel. Number seven, a peace agreement between Israel and Syria is not going to help to improve the international status of the state of Israel, because again, the problem of legitimacy that we suffer from in the international community is created because of the Israel-Palestinian conflict, because of the issue of the occupation of the Palestinians. This is the problem. This is the core of the diplomatic problems of the state of Israel, and it is not going to be positively affected whether we have a peace agreement between Israel and Syria or we do not. To conclude, we can say that a peace agreement between Israel and Syria consists of the four elements that I mentioned in the beginning of my presentation, is a possible deal contrary to the Palestinians. I do believe that the Syrians do intend to achieve such a peace. I do believe that they can implement their part if such a peace agreement is signed. But I'm not sure that it is going to be so important for the state of Israel, and definitely it is not going to solve any of the other problems that I mentioned, neither the problem of the Iranian nuclear project, nor Hezbollah, nor, of course, anything that is related to the Palestinians.